Live from Dallas, Texas, for The Money Show, I'm Adrian Manns. I'm here today with Brian Shannon of AlphaTrends.net. And we were just sort of talking off camera for a little bit about how we use the volume weighted average price and the fact that he does something very similar on a multi-session time frame that I do on an intra-session time frame, and I find that very intriguing. Why don't you tell us how you use the VWAP in your swing trading?
Okay, I first started in volume-weighted average price. I stumbled into it back in 2003 as an indicator on TC2000. I don't know if you know that one.
Yep, absolutely.
But since then, I noticed how often it would act as almost exact intraday support or resistance. Back then, I could only get it intraday. Now, with a couple of software programs, we have the ability to anchor it from any certain spot. So, for instance, right now, we're short shares of Beyond. We're short from 144 and a quarter a week and a half ago. As it broke below the volume weighted average price from the IPO, it also broke below the volume weighted average price from a gap about 3 months after that when there was an earnings report. And since then, it's just been falling out of bed. It's 126 right now. So using multiple timeframes, my book, Multiple Technical Analysis Using Multiple Timeframes, ties in with the volume weighted average price to see the sentiment. Who's in control from any specific point in time? Where do we want to measure from is what becomes our anchor.
So, for instance, intraday, what I do is I've got a 5-minute chart. I find the different swing points on the chart, and I take different trends. I look for the VWAP there. That's where my analysis ends. I've just got overlapping VWAPs over the course of the day. You're triggering from almost headline-driven situations where you're going back and anchoring it to the headline, correct?
Often it is a headline. It could be just a breakout as well.
Okay.
It's whatever changes the sentiment. I view it as the ultimate sentiment indicator.
Sure.
It's price, volume, and time. Well, what time, right? I mean, we could use a 50-day moving average, but that's completely random. The only reason we use that is because that's what everyone uses and that's what we're told to use. But if we say, since an earnings report, you know, since Apple last reported earnings, who's in control, the buyers or sellers? If the VWAP has an upslope to it and it's holding above that, well, the buyers are in control. Similar in the futures market or whatever you're trading intraday, it makes that first swing high, it starts to pull back, anchor one off the peak, and as it pulls back, the bottom one comes up and they converge together. You're buying that little strength in there with a stop just underneath the low. It's just taken out to a larger time frame for, you know, for swing trading.
So this is going to be platform sensitive, right? Because only certain
Correct.
Trading platforms offer.
Right.
So I know Realtek offers it. I know TradeStation has sort of a way that you can do it. TC2000. Are there any other platforms that you recommend, or do you have your own platform?
TC2000,
yeah.
It is called the Anchored Volume Weighted Average Price by Alpha Trends.
There you go.
And then you got Trend Spider,
right.
Which has the same title. So they added that for me just in the last couple months. TradingView has it. It's a little wonky to work with there. You have to go back and set the date for each bar, which, you know, it's point and click so much easier.
Right.
Optima has it, and then Yahoo Finance has it as well. But again, you have to kind of go back and say at 11:38 a.m. on this date, put it in rather than the, you know, convenient point and click.
So, and the seminar that you did here at the Money Show was about this, about how to use that information?
3 p.m. today, yes.
3 p.m. today,
yeah.
So we want to make sure people don't miss that. And if someone wants to get in touch with you or learn more about this and they're not here at the Money Show, how do they do that?
Easiest way is at AlphaTrends on Twitter. I've got a good following there, and I post a lot of information about, you know, I'll be at this trade show, or post a bunch of charts. I've been talking about the Beyond trade before I got involved in it. So it's, you know, I put a lot of stuff out there on Twitter.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you. All right, and for The Money Show, I'm Adrian Manns, live from Dallas, Texas. We'll be back in a minute with more.